The Philippine Statistics Authority making headway in its rollout of national IDs. The agency says, despite delays, nearly 17 million cards have already been delivered out of the 21 million that have been printed. It is also issuing digital copies for those who have yet to receive their physical cards.
Masyado napakabilis talaga yung registration natin. And then yung ating back-end process including card production ay hindi siya gaano kabilis yung pag-scale up. Yung commitment ng PSA to issue 50 million ID credentials ay tinapatan namin ng namin ngayon na to be launched fully this October yung pag-issue ng form of a digital ID, no, yung PDF copy, but for now printed muna siya, and then maybe before the year end ito na talaga yung a mobile ID na pwede na i-receive nila through sa kanilang mga mobile phones. So kung hindi siya end of the year, mga first quarter ng 2023 ay maano na yan, ma-implement na yan.
Back here at home, an IT law expert allays concerns over the implementation of the newly signed SIM card registration law. Attorney J.J. Dicini says there are enough safeguards in the measure to protect the personal information of SIM users. There have been concerns the law may compromise the privacy of individuals and it could be used for government surveillance.
Kung concerns kasi yung hacking or security ng mga telcos, tingin ko, hindi na siya malaking issue. Gawa ng all these years, wala naman tayong narinig or nare-report na compromise ng mga database ng ating mga telco. Yung concern naman about law enforcement harassment, I think nasa batas naman na limited yung authority nila na makuha yung information. Ang personal experience ko sa mga telcos, napakahirap kumuha ng information sa kanila. Kasi ingat na ingat sila sa privacy ng kanilang users. Kasi alam nila na pag hindi nila inalagaan ang privacy ng users nila, masisira ang negosyo nila.
Government programs for the maritime and aviation sectors topped the agenda in the latest cabinet meeting with President Marcos. Office of the Press Secretary Officer in Charge, Eloy Garafil, says Marcos has called for the creation of a maritime industry development plan. He has also instructed authorities to improve the country's ports to accommodate more cruise ships. Garafil adds, Marcos has also ordered the Transportation Department to upgrade the country's main gateways. Several areas in the Philippines placed under signal number 1 due to tropical depression Maymay. Those are Isabela, Quirino, Nueva Vizcaya, Aurora, Nueva Ecija, and extreme northern Quezon, including Polillo Islands. These areas are forecast to experience strong winds in 36 hours. Maymay has sustained winds of 45 kilometers per hour and gusts of up to 55 kilometers per hour. It is forecast to make landfall over southern Aurora or northern Quezon Wednesday. Meanwhile, another weather disturbance is seen to enter the Philippine area of responsibility Thursday. Progressive lawmakers seek a probe into De Lima's hostage-taking incident inside the PNP Custodial Center in Camp Crame. Lawmakers from the Makabayan Bloc have filed a resolution asking the House Committee on Public Order and Safety to conduct its own investigation. They believe De Lima remains at risk and that she should be immediately released from prison. De Lima has been detained for more than 5 years over what she calls trumped-up drug charges by the Duterte administration. Red tagging is part of democracy. That bold statement coming from Philippine Justice Secretary Boying Remulla. Speaking before the United Nations Human Rights Committee in Geneva, Remulla said red tagging is merely a form of criticism on anyone who commits criminal acts. He cited the New People's Army as an example, which he claimed has killed thousands of policemen and soldiers. Various groups have called for a stop to the Philippine government's red tagging efforts, saying it has led to the killing of activists and human rights defenders.